Now, paintings have been used to tell the story of mankind since the beginning of mankind. And I think that if you look at an artist such as Hale Woodruff, in these wonderful murals that he has here in this museum, the Talladega College Museum, now named in my honor, the Dr. William R. Harvey Museum of Art, he told the story of a critically important part of American history, not just African-American history. Whole idea about the Amistad and the revolt, that is something that is important. As I walked through this campus when I was a student, those murals were in the library. Now I see them restored, telling that story of that revolt. It is a wonderful story that people, black and white, will be able to see, to tell for decades to come. I am just so proud of the fact that Dr. Hawkins, others have contributed to bringing these murals alive. That's the whole idea. Because again, a picture is worth a thousand words. That's how I see it.
In 1938, Talladega College in Central Alabama commissioned artist Hale Woodruff to paint a series of six murals for its new Savory Library. The murals portray events in the rise of American blacks from slavery to freedom. During Woodruff's own time, the Talladega murals emerged as symbols of achievement and optimism for African Americans, and their message has transcended the decades.
Hale Woodruff was commissioned to paint two sets of murals for Talladega College. The first set he painted in 1939 for the grand opening of Savory Library about the Amistad Mutiny. The second set he painted for the founding of the college, but he always considered the two sets to really be one collection.
The first three, which show the Amistad uprising, the Amistad case is considered the first civil rights case in the country. The Africans, after taking over the Amistad ship from the Spanish, they were captured near New York City and put on trial. And the question was, were they born in Africa, which made them free men and gave them the right to defend themselves? Or were they born in the Caribbean, which meant that they were slaves and therefore property and didn't have that right? It was ruled that they were born in Africa. They did have the right to defend themselves. It gets appealed up to the Supreme Court. John Quincy Adams, former president, staunch abolitionist, he comes out of retirement to argue on behalf of the Africans. And it's again reaffirmed that yes, they did have the right to defend themselves. And it's also the first instance of a European or a white court saying that Africans or black people have the exact same rights that white people have. At a time where slavery is legal, was a pretty radical concept.
To help the viewer work their way through the story that's being told in these canvases, Woodruff plants little details that helps us connect between the canvases. One of my favorites is this sort of collection, this little still life ensemble of evidence that's laid out at the trial on a table right before the judge. You take a look at it, and of course, you recognize the K-knives from the mutiny. Well, take a close look at the hat. It resembles the hat that's being worn by the captain as he's in the process of being slain in the mutiny. And of course, we have the shirt, which is the shirt that may or may not have been worn by the cook, who's also in the process of being killed by the mutineers.
Second set of murals, which show a scene of the Underground Railroad. It shows the first day of registration. It shows the building of Savory Library. And in all three of those paintings, you see there are black people and white people working together. So that focuses more on unity instead of the fight for freedom. And I think that's an important part for the university too, because Talladega College was always integrated.
So I thought that the murals represented diversity. It represented some sort of equality and unity in the nation as well, because there were people who were fighting for us that didn't look like us.
It's amazing that Dr. Bill Gallagher, the president of Talladega College, at the age of 30 years old, had the foresight to commission these murals by Hale Woodruff.
Hale Woodruff's journey to Talladega started in 1931 when he was invited to start an art program at Atlanta University Center. Woodruff began teaching art classes at Talladega College in 1938 at the invitation of the college's president, Buell Gallagher. That same year, Gallagher commissioned Woodruff to paint a series of murals for the new library. Gallagher selected themes to celebrate the history of the college, its founding story, reaching back to the momentous uprising on the slave ship Amistad. The college planned to open the new library on the centennial of the 1839 mutiny.
And of course, during that time, Hale Woodruff was, the typical artist who would just paint small frame artwork and really did not have the background to paint murals of that type.
Hale went right to work, studying Talladega's history, researching the Amistad Revolt, and traveling to Mexico, where he studied with internationally renowned muralist Diego Rivera. He wanted to learn the style and technique to best capture the colors and realism. The murals devoted to La Amistad capture the epic tale of 53 Africans who in 1839 were captured from the west coast of Africa and sold into the Spanish slave trade. En route to Havana, Cuba, Joseph Sink, the group's leader, took over the ship and insisted that it be returned to Africa. Instead, the crew sailed into Long Island Sound, where the United States Navy seized the ship and took it to New Haven. Outraged by the situation, former President John Quincy Adams, the most prominent national leader opposing slavery at the time, fought for the freedom of these slaves, bringing them to New Haven before the United States Supreme Court.
Woodruff captures these historical moments in the three canvases with real energy and bright, bright, wonderful colors and a lot of uplifting messages that they carry throughout.
The abolitionists who helped the Africans who staged the Amistad Mutiny later established the American Missionary Association, or the AMA.
The public at large, and perhaps even blacks here in the city, never thought of this as anything other than paintings. And they really didn't know that much about the history of the paintings and what they really meant, not only to Talladega, but they had meant the creation of the American Missionary Association, which established, these colleges in the South as integrated colleges.
Well, my favorite mural is the fifth one, first day of registration at Talladega College. It shows the students coming to register for classes. You can see Swain School in the background, the first building. They were former slaves, so they were never paid for any of the work that they did, so they couldn't afford tuition. So they were able to bring crops that they grew, they brought their livestock, just whatever they took to pay that fee, including helping to build the school, because once again, they had learned all these crafts and skills during slavery, and they put those to use at the college, building buildings, helping maintain the land, which was very important because at the time in the 1860s and 1870s, being a black college in Alabama wasn't a safe place. We actually had a teacher that was lynched. And so the school had to be self-sufficient. They had to grow their own food. They had to have their own buildings for the faculty and staff to live in. And that also shows how important the education was to them, that they had this external threat of this danger, this threat of lynching, this threat of the school being burnt down. And despite that, they're willing to put up with that threat and still come to school and get their education.
And we can't forget that Woodruff painted these murals for a specific audience. And the audience, of course, were generations of college students who would walk through Savory Library, see these every day, and have an experience with them. Some of the details, Woodruff describes himself as being put in there specifically for comic relief and to engage the students that he was trying to draw in as his audience. And it's kind of interesting because he really wants to make this experience enjoyable and also instructive.
The theme of the Amistad was largely unknown when the paintings were commissioned. The Talladega murals would be the first visual representation of the Amistad, and Woodruff was well aware of this important fact.
After the tour, they'll return back to Talladega, where they've always been appreciated, and now they'll be on view for generations to come.
Seeing the murals actually hung here in the library, you never imagined they were so huge, so massive. So, just seeing them on the walls at the museum, it was like let me get back. Yeah, they were like, phew, phew, yeah.
I like that the murals, they are a direct reflection of the growth of the school. because the school started as one room in one man's house, and now it's, we have acres, there are buildings, there's new construction going on, so the murals reflect that, the growth that Talladega College has had since 1867.
These murals tell a story that is worldwide as far as the struggle of African Americans from then until now. And the struggle continues. However, this story goes from the struggle to how education can impact that struggle.
These murals are part of this institution. We've always been known for academic excellence right from its beginning back in 1867. So today, not only are we known for academic excellence, but we are known for the home of the Amistad murals.